Now I guess maybe it's on. Alright, I think I'm live. Hopefully. So I had a lot planned for tonight, and then I just got really in the mood to go back to the world of Life is Strange, so I guess here I am. I bought the episodes as they came out, and then I bought the, limited edition shit, so... I mean, because, like, you know, at that point I was already, like, way too obsessed with this stuff. Speaking of being obsessed, I'm reading the comics as they come out. Whatever the fuck the author is doing to my poor little heart right now. I see that blue butterfly. I see it. The author is fucking murdering me right now. I don't know where they're gonna go with this at this point. Hopefully, it's that, like, no matter in what fucking timeline, strand of whatever, hopefully they're gonna have Max and Chloe together, but it seems like that's what the author wanted, and then they were like, haha, you never know. So, it's stressing me out, but collector mode restart. What? So can I just go to, like, a new save? Okay. Cool. Is that how that works? That's weird as fuck, but... probably good. I guess there we go then. What a weird way to, like, get to a new file. But here we are then. Starting right off. And before I push this, I'm gonna make sure I sound okay. That was quick. Live is so behind of what I am, but, like, everything looks good and I sound good, so. Then off we go. We play as Bay in this one. Just saying. Not that, like, I don't connect with Max, but... choose wisely again. I've only played this once, actually. I've seen it... twice? I've played it once? I swear to God. I mean, you know, you might have not been afraid of trains then, and then after you get your fucking boot caught in the tracks, hopefully you're a little bit afraid of them.
I can't believe Firewalk is playing a show at the old mill. Fuck yes.
Alright. Okay, so we are younger.
Mom,
Chloe.
Mom would kill me if she knew I was out here.
Max has left, and Chloe's descending into before blue hairdom. Yeah. The fucking camera is, like, crazy sensitive, but okay. Maybe I should put my head on the other side, because they're, like, kind of... next time! I thought
Holy
I remembered you did
shit.
That, and also I feel you.
This place is awesome.
Absolutely. Okay, so,
if I'm gonna get inside, I'll have to get through that door.
It tells you her objective on her hand. Alright, get inside the mill. So since I love voice actors, I want to point out that this is a different voice actor than original Chloe's, and still she manages to fucking nail it. So, that's pretty cool.
If I owed somebody $1,000, I'd be shitting my pants.
Like, it's different. And yet, really good. And by the way, she owes Frank, what, 1,500 in the first one? It's more than 1,000.
That's exactly your problem.
Those guys need to get a room.
Well...
or not. Damn.
Maybe it's, business.
Foreplay. I don't know.
I understand.
Minding my own business? So that's Frank's RV, I'm pretty sure.
This RV's just begging for a little street art. But if I do it here, someone will see me.
Yeah, I got you, Chloe. Let's go. I gotta change the sensitivity on this fucking camera. It's crazy high. I guess, whatever, next time.
Ah, perfect place for me to work.
Ah, let's do it.
Now, what to draw?
Both are so good. Apparently,
definitely,
I didn't pick that one before.
Absolutely not a meth lab.
I love it. So she can draw like really fucking well, apparently. These are just what, her random drawings? People she knows. Aw, poor Max. She actually writes in a journal. Oh yeah! Press from Blade Runner. And that's where she got the hair. Aww. You'll do your hair blue soon. That's fucking awesome. Max doesn't answer. Look at, like, Chloe's trying to make a combo and... You know, Max is fucking lucky that Chloe still wants her when she comes back. Like, sorry, but you can't leave my girl like that. Okay, anyway. This fucking sensitive ass camera. I'm never gonna get over it. I should just change it now, but I also don't want to.
Guess fire safety isn't exactly high on the agenda here.
Yeah, I would put that like nowhere near this bonfire. I think I remember how to get it, but I'm exploring.
This place has collected a lot of junk over the years.
Well, bust the door open, Chloe.
This band shreds so hard. I gotta get in there.
It's cool because I don't usually listen to like that kind of music, but if it's live, I'd have a lot of fun. Like, I feel like it doesn't matter what it is live, I'll like it, but I'm really particular with what I listen to not live, if that makes any sense.
I've got to figure out how to get past this guy.
She swag walks up.
You gotta let me in.
Hey, what's up, man?
I'm totally legit.
Why would you even bother with that? I would just be like, hey, bro, what's up?
It's not a bad fake, kid, but you're in over your head here. Do yourself a favor and scram.
They vibrated when he threw it at her.
Can't let him push me around. Should I go back and stand up to him? Or can something around here help me convince him?
Both, probably, but let's see.
Nothing says badass like a nice floral print.
You're right, Chloe, but at the same time, it kind of is a nice floral print. Anyway, that's what I think he needs, so I'm pretty sure. Let's talk to you again. my god, I have to change this. I have to change. No, stop it. Stop. Literally, no. It's already that low? Make it lower. Like... Maybe that's a little too low. Cut the fuck on. Okay, let's try that. I mean, but like, whatever. It's gonna have to be good enough because. Swear to God.
Again? What do you want, kid?
Alright.
Is that your bike over there?
Yup.
It's, pretty cool.
Gee, thanks. Is that all?
No, but now that she knows it's his bike, she can say something different, I think. I don't know, whatever.
This is the old mill, right? I heard Firewalk is playing here tonight. They're awesome.
Nope.
Are you kidding?
You should probably just go.
Ah, man. Alright, backtalk challenge.
I have to convince this doorstop that I'm not giving up until he lets me inside.
So I'm gonna do what you want. Alright, let's go. I know my head's in the way, but I...
what it's like to be a teenager?
I got the idea.
I just want to see the band.
I thought we went over this.
Alright.
Isn't it past your bedtime?
Alright. Mm-hmm. Yep, use bedtime against them. Got you. I'll be
like... Aww. Isn't it past yours?
Because he's old, get it?
Real cute.
He's not really that old, but to her. Okay. Cute. Got it.
Look at my face. Do I look cute?
Yes.
Or do I look like I'm going to kick your ass?
You look cute as fuck.
Okay,
but it's fine.
Kid. I get it. You're tough.
And cute. Playground for kid, got it.
Maybe I am a kid. Because this place looks like a damn playground to me.
It is a little bit, but
a girl like you? I can't protect you in there.
And then now we
like
know this. That's
with
what
pretty,
I was thinking. Hell
yeah.
On
her bicycle shouldn't lecture me on what I can do.
That is a traditional Samoan.
It is. But I like it.
Look, my boss decides who gets in, all right?
Is your boss your mom? Follow up. Do you live in your boss's basement?
Basement?
You're not accepting no
for
an
her
answer.
Childhood room still.
Nope.
One day I'll move out.
And you really think you can take me?
Yep.
What if I had a knife?
No problem.
I'd be fucked.
Don't care.
What if I had...
You could have a flamethrower, an army of robot ninjas, and a motherfucking dragon on a leash in there, and I'd still kick your ass.
I give up. You're all right, kid. Go on.
Because it's Chloe, I'd kind of... Yeah, probably. I love her a lot. I'm okay. Huh. All right, firewalk time.
This is intense.
Shit.
Hey, Delia, come.
Cute dog.
It is. You also shouldn't cut a pit bull's ears. Just what I think. I like, they look cute, Floppy. Why would you bother? Whatever. You guys can do what you want. If it didn't hurt,
just follow the lights
and
the
I
sound.
Was, and it did it, and my parents did it as a child, like made them look like elves or something. That'd be cool as fuck. But anyway, no, you don't pet someone random's dog. You can look at
that
it.
That dog is fierce.
Or cute. You just said cute. No, we're not gonna pet his dog. It could bite you.
Half those stairs are rotted through.
Not even that, it could just bite you. Okay, if I had a dog, I don't. But if I had a dog and it was walking along with me, don't pet it. Because it's going to be licking me later. And if it licks you, I don't want your residue lick on me. Yeah?
Frank Bowers? What is he doing here?
Whatever
Yo,
he wants.
Frank!
Yo!
Hey!
Alright, someone's high. Hey!
Chloe?
I know your name, you idiot. You bought pot for me every month for a year. Look at that getup. Studs. You're trying too hard.
You mean being cute. Look how cute.
What are you even doing here?
I'm here to see Firewalk, man. They rock.
Alright.
How'd you even hear about this little shindig?
Ha, the internet. How else?
Seriously? Fucking kids.
Like, duh, okay. Well, I don't want to just be like, later. I mean, we know him later. I mean, like, she speaks to him enough that she knows who he is by, like, just looking at him. So, I'm not going to be like, how about some weed right now? Chloe might say that, but...
So, you come here a lot, or...?
Yeah.
Right. It's cool.
She's so awkward, I love it. Well, I guess we can ask
him. Okay, so, you holding? I could definitely use something to take the edge off.
Of course. As soon as you give me the 175 bucks you owe me.
That's a figure, man.
Do
I
really owe him that much? Unless I find some quick cash around here, I can kiss my high goodbye.
Sorry, Chloe.
How about you spot me some? You know I'm good for it.
No way. I learned my lesson last time.
I feel like she would ask.
First.
All right, yeah, I got you. I got
Never
you.
Never mind, then.
Suit yourself.
All right. Yeah, yeah, I feel that. Yeah.
Reminds me of the way I make important life choices.
Yeah, you know what, Chloe? You know what? You know what? Although that might not be a great idea. Sometimes it is.
How can you just chill when Firewalk is tearing it up in the next room?
Because she's a chill girl. How could she not just chill? No. Alright.
Can you talk louder, please?
Is that guy selling merch?
Okay, good.
Wish I had some cash.
That's
you know
exactly
you don't have
mean,
cash.
You.
And you know you can't just take it.
They're gonna sell out.
So...
Looks like that parking brake is the only thing keeping that car from rolling down the ramp.
Honestly, like, wouldn't it be more than that,
no,
but...
No, no, no.
Looks like
can't
that
you,
parking
can't
brake
you pull
is the
it?
Only
Chloe,
thing
Chloe.
Keeping that car from rolling down
Chloe,
the ramp.
I know. Are you supposed to actually, like, talk to him for...
No. Look, we have to set this up exactly as I'm...
That
you're not gonna take
round.
It yet. I mean, I want you to take one.
No.
Look. Hey, are you selling
20
any...
20 bucks.
What?
20 bucks for a t-shirt.
That's...
It's not...
really expensive.
Not. I paid $35.40 for a fucking t-shirt.
No.
Chloe... Now that you know that, I don't want you to just take it. I want, like, you to pull the parking brake and then...
Hey, I told you 20 bucks. You looking to get beat?
That guy's a dick. If I want a shirt, I'm going to need to get creative.
I am. You're going to pull the parking brake, but, like, I thought you were going to do that already. Look, bruh. Pull it.
Sorry, dude. Maybe you shouldn't overcharge.
Well, it's not really overcharging. I mean, obviously, maybe it is if he's homemade
Shit.
Them, but...
No! Come on!
Take one and run. Now you gotta figure out how to tow your car
paying,
out.
Dick.
Don't wave to him. Just take it.
Oh, yeah. Sweet, sweet victory.
Okay. I would not do any of this in real life. I just want to let you know, everyone.
That's like 200 bucks.
Chloe, okay, I know Chloe. I just know her. I know, I'm sorry. I wouldn't do this.
Holy
Chloe
shit.
Probably would. Maybe you shouldn't do things that would probably put you in prison, but at the same time...
Nothing sadder than a neglected bong.
There's a lot sadder. You're in trouble now, so let's, like, get a move on and go to the show so then no one notices what you did. Please, don't talk to the sleazy guys. Let's go.
Here we go.
Okay, yeah, anyway, I wouldn't do any of this. I feel like Chloe would.
Fuck.
My playstyle this time.
Hey, you okay?
I'm fine.
Relax.
Ew.
You bumped into me.
You're like 40, man. Yeah, we all apologize. Yeah. Oh, sorry.
My bad, dude.
You don't know who I am, do you?
Nope.
Bye.
Don't care either.
Hey, let me know how that works out for you, bitch.
All right. Mosh pit is a no-go. Fine.
You're gonna climb up those dicey stairs
Maybe
now.
Maybe I can get a better view of the action.
New dialogue unlocked. Dialogue for who?
Bumping into my drug dealer at the firework show.
Hold on.
She returns.
Did you see that guy I ran into? Acted like I was supposed to know who the hell he was.
Yeah. I know him. He works for Damon.
Damon Merrick?
I see you've heard of him. This is his place. Damon's a friend of mine.
Where do those stairs go?
Up.
Duh, man.
Real helpful, Frank. I mean, will I get a better view of the band up there?
How the fuck should I know? Floor above's rotted all to hell, okay? No one goes up there.
I'm bad. Can I pay him now?
I'll see you later.
If I had the option,
whatever.
I would have taken the 200 and paid him. Because he said he wanted 175. Whatever, go. I would have paid him. Maybe not right there. Because, like, obviously you didn't have it before. Whatever. The next time you see him, pay him. And besides that, I want to play a little bit like what I think Chloe would do and a little bit like what I would do. Because certain things I'm like, I don't know how efficient or not she was back then.
Finally made it! I can't believe it!
So. I won't do what I would do, but I'm not gonna do fully what I think she would do. Because I think maybe she might get into a little bit more trouble than she should. It's a limited edition. Copyright me. Oh, no. With the limited edition, I'll let her jam with a vinyl came with the game. And it's all, like, peaceful songs and then this. Which is kind of funny. Jam. Hey. Okay.
You spilled my beer, bitch!
Okay, are you still on that? Just go get another one. It's probably like
you
fucking cheap as shit beer.
It's a rough place.
I don't like your attitude.
Hey, I'm sorry about the beer, okay?
Not good enough.
I tried, man.
We're not done.
I am. My only option is to insult, and I'm gonna try not to.
And how about I show you how unimpressed I am with limp dick assholes who get butthurt over a spilled beer?
I think she's calling us out, dude.
She's gonna regret every word. Every word.
Oh, this is gonna be good.
I'm gonna teach this little punk some manners.
I'm serious. You wanna see me get angry here? Because I'm getting there. And it won't be pretty. It won't.
She thinks she can take you?
Hey, dickhead.
Run.
Rachel?
Attacking her. We run as quick as we fucking can.
If you still have a gun, so watch yourself as a chain. Lost, no one gave it to
remember this one.
Go, Frank!
Not gonna happen. Calm down. Come on, man! Walk away. Screw this! Bullshit. Get the fuck out of here!
I have it in gift form. Okay. He works for Damon. A friend of Frank. All right. Oh, fabulous. There's so many middle fingers in this. I gotta get it out now so I don't do it at work. I don't talk about it. Don't sleep in your jeans. Just. She's gonna say something stupid about drinking beer, and I didn't make her drink any beer, I think. So, hold on. Because you can, I'm pretty sure. If you can't, she thinks about it. I am. But whatever. She's not old enough. Good to get so addicted to cigarettes that you have to do one when you wake up, man. Wake and bake was one thing. And you want to wake and smoke weed, that's one thing. I'm okay with that. Wake and cigarette. I don't know, man. But you can't afford the weed if Frank won't give it to you. Oh, Chloe, instead of running away to L.A., you should run away to Chicago.
Sometimes all I want to do is shut my eyes and tell the world to go to hell. Daily rituals are important.
All right.
Even when they involve writing unread letters to friends who have forgotten you.
Oh, my heart. Oh, my God, it hurts. Okay. He's my dealer, and you shouldn't be reading this. Honestly, okay, so she says it was the greatest night of my life, and that's hilarious because, well, not even hilarious, but like, wow, same. If I had to pick, I don't think I have a greatest night of my life, but if I had to, it ties for so many times that I've gone to concerts. So many different concerts, so many different shows, festivals. There's so many that tie for that's the greatest night of my life. So it music, like, same, Chloe. Fuck. Fuck Seattle. Aww. No big deal, but... How was your night, loser? It's just so fucking sad that she, like, titles it to Max, or, like, is writing it to Max. My ship. My ship! Okay. I'm okay. How are you? Is there something else I'm supposed to look at? What's with this angle? Oh.
Hey, Max. Hey, Dad. Another day in paradise.
They're so cute. Wow.
Last night, seeing Firewalk live. Those skeevy assholes. That girl.
That's me. After leaving a show, I'm like,
really, Rachel Amber?
There's so many things I have to think about, and yet I have to think about nothing.
Smell like cigarettes and beer. Better change clothes.
It's like there's so many things I have to think about, and yet I don't have to think about anything. Like, that was amazing. I love it. I love it.
Fun fact. Shark babies eat their siblings in the womb. Maybe that's why I'm an only child.
You never know. Maybe, Chloe. That doesn't sound like accurate science to humans, but you never know. I have the DLC and everything because I got the limited edition shit, so I can pick whatever I want. What clothes should I wear? The one she stole, duh. Why can't I do that? There we go. I was like, what the fuck? Hell yeah, you're putting on the shirt you just stole. All you're doing is going to school, right? I love it. Yo, fuck yeah, let's go. I wear band t-shirts and shit, everything. Except, this. This is accurate. Absolutely. Killing it.
I really should get going.
So you don't want me to explore? Is that what you just said? It lies.
Max made me this mix CD years ago. And because it was Max, not a single song was pirated.
Listen, Chloe. Back in the day, I used to pirate songs. But if you really like them, you might as well purchase them if you want to support the artist.
As awesome as some of those shows with Elliot were, they were nothing compared to Firewalk last night.
Aww, that's fun. Wait, 2 month anniversary. So are they dating or just like friends for 2 months? That's a lot of shows for 2 months. Confused. A little bit. Yeah.
Yeah.
Let's leave now.
Shit. Where's my phone? God, it's not here. How drunk was
I last
night?
Here she goes with the comment. You weren't.
I said breakfast.
Guess I better try calling my phone with Mom's.
I would be like, all right, Mom. Like, at least make it known that you heard her, you know what I'm talking about? You weren't drunk. You literally didn't drink anything.
Mom's phone is probably
You didn't smoke anything either, because
I can use it to call mine, then figure out where the hell I left it.
You didn't smoke anything either, because I didn't. You didn't get any. You don't have money for that. Okay, well, you know.
How can Mom look at this every day and not see what a tool she's dating?
Chloe. He saves all of your lives later. But not yet, so I get it. Alright.
Sounds like my phone is definitely nearby.
I know where it is, so it's fine.
There we go.
I don't know why the
Wonder
fuck
how many there. Calls I've missed.
So popular, Chloe. Okay. Oh, God. God, Chloe. Okay, Elliot. So this is her friend who she just went to all those shows with. I do know everything. Okay, the problem is, she's actually really smart. She just doesn't give a shit about the class she's actually in, because none of it's actually enriching her, so she just kind of just, you know? To be honest, she's more, like, to me, it seems like she would fit more in a vocational, like, what she wants to do school, and that's that. Like, it's not like she's not smart. She's super smart.
Chloe, breakfast. Bring my purse down with you, please.
Yeah. Okay.
There you go. Now she at least knows
you
that.
You think I saw Mom's purse in her room?
I did. Let's go. No, I didn't, but let's
Mom's
snoop.
Old engagement ring. Supposed to be mine, if I'm ever stupid enough to get married.
That's a max.
Grade B? Fuck you, Arcadia Pawn. Wait, Mom's selling her engagement ring?
Shit. Wow, okay. It's giving me the little, like, you can talk to her about that. Fucking want to talk to her about that. It's stressful as fuck. That's her decision. It's not yours, Chloe. It's really not.
Ah, Mom. Bad enough that David comes here for dinner.
She closes it with her foot. Same, I fucking love it. Let's not look through her phone. That would be stupid.
I made this for Mom when I was like 10 years old.
Aww.
If she wore it now, I'm not sure which of us would be more embarrassed.
That's so fucking cute.
I hate that she hides all our old pictures of Dad.
Put it up.
What's the matter, Mom? You don't want Dad to see your new boyfriend?
Or the other way around, but you know what? I don't fucking care. It happened, and everyone knows about it, and we love him. And no one is ashamed.
You don't deserve to be stuck in a drawer like this.
Thank you. I wouldn't. Look how fucking cute. It happened, and it was fabulous, and everyone should be proud of it, because that's how Chloe was born. Thank you. I know it's sad, I get it. But come on. Sorry, but if my husband or wife died and I had a kid with them, like, I'd be fucking still proud. Whatever, where's your purse?
Chloe, breakfast.
Dude, where is your... There's your purse. I've snooped enough. I'll get your purse.
Oh, can you grab my cell phone, too?
Mom, wow, you asked for so
many
things.
No more dawdling. I need to talk to you.
Okay, that is,
Yeah, that really makes me want to hurry.
Yeah, that makes me want to hurry so much less that I'll actually look one more. I wouldn't go through
it's
her phone.
It's weird
but...
that Mom's always hoarding these old catalogs. It's not like we have any money.
Sometimes you just collect things that you don't really mean to collect, you know? It's fine. Okay, let's go.
Coming, Mom.
Not even in the Life is Strange comics, if this is a spoiler, sorry, do you see Max's house. They never show you her house. Or her parents.
Finally, you can put
she
my
has them.
On the dining table. Might still have time for breakfast.
They're just not important to the story, I guess, if you think about it. I have a lot to say about that, but
dining
I'll try
table,
not to.
Here I come.
Okie dokie. No, wait.
Dad took these photos.
Aww.
Now that David's staying over so much, I wonder how long it'll take Mom to shove them in a drawer somewhere.
We're not gonna let her.
Chloe, I don't have all day. Would you get over here already?
Look at the deadpan expression.
She should see what Mom wants before she strokes out.
Alright, no stroking.
Dad's old swear jar. We spent the last of his curses on bus fare and milk.
Aw. That's $1 to the swear jar. You mean your college
book? Hey, Mom. You wanted to talk?
When I send you a text message, Chloe, like last night, I need
Sorry.
You to answer.
You can just say text. You don't have to say message.
And
She's
I need
wrong.
You to answer without the snark.
I love Joyce. A lot. I think in anything she does, she is a fucking fantastic mother. And feel really bad for her. So, I don't want to be like, I was sleeping. I don't want to lie. But at the same time, like, what would Chloe do? This is hard. Sorry, I'll do better.
Sorry. I hear you. I'll do better about replying.
What the
Thank
fuck?
You.
Is that what
I don't
you
know if you heard
about?
That, but I didn't.
What is it with you and
stupid
David?
Stupid shit control.
Always cutting to the chase. Why can't we just have some pleasant conversation before school?
Volume. Oh my god. Okay, so we can talk about her engagement ring because we found it. Chloe would.
Are you selling your engagement ring?
Chloe, jewelry gets appraised for all sorts of reasons. Like for insurance.
Chloe, why would you Chris talk Dodge. About that?
How about this? You don't go in my bedroom when I'm not there.
You How told
you me
to.
You don't ask me to get your damn purse then.
Okay, I feel bad about that whole conversation. Listen. Chloe would say that. I would be like, what's up? We're not going to talk about David.
Ah, right. School. My favorite.
You used to love to learn.
Let's be nice.
Yeah.
Please be nice. Please be nice.
I used to think drugs were lame, too.
Let's be nice. The rest of that, that was mean. I'm sorry. Fuck. I hit the button like twice.
You do realize I hate your boyfriend with every fiber of my being, right?
Chloe. You don't hate him.
He calls me girly. He's a dickhole.
He can be old-fashioned.
Yeah. An old-fashioned dickhole.
Let's not fight. I made you breakfast.
Okay, be nice, be nice.
I'll just...
No, Chloe. Eat it. I know, parents.
Oh,
eat it.
Oh, you'll enjoy this. The other day I made
you
four
won't enjoy
eggs,
it.
Two for David, two for me. And just
Joyce,
before I served
stop.
Them, he says,
stop.
What are you gonna eat?
I'll enjoy that, huh?
Chloe.
Firewalk? Is that the band you mentioned last week?
I'm still bummed you wouldn't let me go.
Mm-hmm.
What?
She knows you at...
I know what time you came home last night. And don't think you can get out of school just because you missed the bus again.
Why would you assume that...
Who do you think your principal calls when you skip? Do you think I enjoy lying for you, saying you're sick just so you don't get expelled?
Mom, I'm sorry. Look, I love her.
Between your grades and your disregard for my
rules...
This is
horrible. I'm terrible.
I see you slipping. I'm worried.
But, Mom, the whole point of lowering expectations is so you won't be disappointed in me.
Chloe.
Ever again.
I get it, but Chloe.
You're happy doing what you're doing? Fine. Keep at it. Just let me know so I can stop fighting with Blackwell to keep you on scholarship. Money's tight enough.
She gets expelled and... She gets expelled anyway. I mean, we know the future, but... No, I'm not gonna say maybe David could help.
Maybe I just need to be left alone.
Maybe you're 16 and don't know what you need.
That's better
David
than
thinks
saying...
you need discipline.
David should mind his own business.
I think it's great David's taking an interest. He's a good man. Maybe he can help.
No, you could help. I'm not gonna call him an asshole. I'd rather do this.
Dad was a good man.
That's not fair. I'm glad your father still has a place in your heart. But sometimes we need to make more room in our hearts for new people.
And sometimes, when we're incredibly desperate and lonely, we choose the absolute wrong kind of people to let into our hearts. Mom.
Chloe.
David's had some hard times too, you know. If he's kind enough to share his experience, I expect you to listen.
Like I'd let him get within 15 feet of me.
When he takes you to school today.
Oh.
Very funny.
That's like 3 feet, two.
You will be nice. You will be respectful. And you will say thank you.
Are you serious?
Hell yeah, I will, because it's Joyce and I care about
this
you.
Is such what,
no, no,
Chloe?
Yeah, yeah. Chloe.
Such what?
Chloe, yes.
Mom's trying.
She is. I love her. Let's
Maybe
do
I
it.
Should too. But what's the point in getting along if it means pretending everything's fine when it's not?
We love Joyce, so no.
Mom, I know you're dealing with a lot.
Thank you. I understand you.
Thank
don't
you
need
indeed.
Me as much anymore,
oh my goodness.
But I need you.
I do still need you.
Thank God.
You're my mom.
Thank God.
I'm proud of you for being so self-sufficient. But the whole world's not out to get you.
Tell that to the world.
You're impossible. But I
was like getting
you.
Nervous there. I was like,
I
they're not gonna
too.
Even give me the option
mm-hmm.
that
Okay, David's waiting. You'll need to bring him his keys from the ashtray.
Okay.
Try not to kill each other.
Got it.
Okay, thank God.
Unless he tries to give me advice. Or looks at me funny.
Chloe.
Or looks at me at all.
Chloe.
Okay.
Mom.
Have a good day.
No.
You too.
Bringing David his keys is about the most humiliating thing Mom can ask me to do.
No, Chloe, there are much more humiliating things. Bringing him his keys is absolutely no big deal, and I'm thankful that Joyce thought good of us at the end there, because you said some very unnecessary things, Chloe. Because I kind of thought she would say them. Okay, let's take them. She holds them like they're infested. It's fine.
Let's get these to David so he can drive away. No point in putting off the inevitable torture of driving to school with David. I better get going.
Let's do it. Who walks like that? Okay, looks like we have to go get a DVD. Oh my goodness. The half-painted house because David didn't paint it.
The car, too.
LOL, Chloe. Wow. That was an awkward, cute little hop.
Why do women always take forever to get ready?
Excuse me.
We're hoping you
and literally walked out the door. Also that. Don't do that.
No, Mom. I swear he beat himself to death with a tire iron. Repeatedly.
Electrode insulator's probably cracked. You know what a spark plug does?
Yeah.
Yes.
It ignites.
Did you not hear me? I said I know what it does.
Okay, Chloe. I would have just been like,
go grab my socket wrench set from the garage, and we can get moving.
Okay.
What is this? Quality time? Better just get the socket wrench and get this over with.
What if he didn't fix it in time and, like, you didn't get to school and then they said it was your fault and you were like, it's actually not.
What's David doing? Leaving stuff in our garage anyway?
It's a tiny garage.
Does he think he's moving in or something?
It's fine. Chloe, shush.
There's his stupid socket wrench set. 50-50 chance I smash him in the face with this. 60-40. Maybe 90-10.
That's how I think about how gay I am. 60-40. 90-10. 95-5. Go ahead, take it.
A little more hustle wouldn't have killed you.
I hustled as fast as physically possible. Ish.
See what's gunking up the works there? That's a sign of
carbon deposits. No shit.
You know, you could actually be good at this if you lost the attitude.
Why?
My attitude is what makes
me
special, David.
It's true.
All right.
Oh, just do it.
Fine. Whatever.
She wiped it off. Chloe. Oh.
Hey, you're taking those tools with you, right?
Every house needs a good toolbox.
Not that big.
We've already got one.
Big
tool. Thanks.
Don't make fun of my old dad's toolbox, this asshole.
Ready to roll?
Please don't want to talk. Please don't want to talk.
I
want
to talk to you about something.
No. Fuck.
We don't have to like each other, but you will respect me. You've enjoyed
enough of a vacation
from having a father figure. So there's some things I want to be real clear
about.
I'm not
sure. I just know hers is different. No, we're not going to be mean. Ignore it. Ignore it. Just ignore it.
Joyce, your mother, she's hurting, Chloe.
I know. Just
hurting for you. You've had it rough, no doubt about it. But all this staying out late, ignoring her command, drinking, drug use, it's making everything harder.
I know, but shush.
You need to shape up.
Let Chloe do what she needs to do.
Get your act together. And put someone else first for a damn change.
I have.
Am I
she
making
has.
Myself clear?
They all left.
Is
That's what you're not
that
getting,
part
man.
Of what David's saying makes
it
sense.
It does.
To me.
It does make sense. And at the same time, got it. Just say nothing.
You
Look,
don't know how lucky you are to have a mother like Joyce.
Actually, yeah, I do.
She's an amazing woman.
I do. I know
you.
That.
It's true, but it's only because she loves you. Problem is,
I know.
You don't learn discipline that way.
It's fine. I get
Give
it.
Me
I do.
One chance to show her how things could be, and you'll be singing a different tune. Mark my words.
Don't change me. I don't change Joyce, and we're all fine. It's fine. Yeah, say nothing is a good choice there. He has good intentions. He just goes about it wrong. Joyce has good intentions. She just goes about it. Chloe has great intentions as well. She just goes about it wrong.
Country?
You're all great
music.
People. Just fucking...
Dad loved this song.
Unless she sings it, then it's cute.
What a beautiful day.
It is.
I know what a spark plug does, jerkwad.
So we know it's a dream, as she just said, and also because, she knows the future and also the past.
If Mom were here, she'd tell me to turn that
present?
Joke off.
Because she's me and hates country.
Dad, turn it up.
Aww.
This isn't right.
Ew. He didn't birth you. Not right.
Again, I'm a lover from the grocery store.
I hate it. Why would they do that to me? I hate it. No. No. And no.
Hey.
The hell?
Out of the car, Chloe. You're gonna be late.
She just took a casual nap. Say thank you.
Shit. Thanks.
Don't use that sarcastic tone with me, young lady. I can see you rolling.
Doesn't
your eyes.
Matter. Mom
Hello?
Said.
I was actually saying.
I see everything.
Whatever. Mom said that to tell
I'll
me.
I'll warn everything.
Mom's told me to tell you thank you. So I said thanks. Shut up, bitch.
Hello, Black Hell.
Alright. Here we are. Well. I'm glad Mom saw us good, because I love her. There was just, some teenaged angst that needed to get out, because that's Chloe. That's the definition of Chloe. But I love her. Stage play going on. Oh,
hey,
who it is.
Chloe.
Oh, hey, Elliot.
I heard you had a hell of a night. I mean, people are talking about it.
What the fuck are you
who
talking
exactly
about?
Who exactly is talking shit about me?
You know, haters on social media.
About what?
Great. I wish I could tell everyone to just get a life.
Seriously, she had
so,
fun.
So, how about The Tempest? Blackwell Theater at its most pretentious.
Yeah. Yep. Totally.
I know it's gonna be lame, but
I was thinking, do you want to go together tomorrow?
No way. I'd rather have my eyes gouged out with rusted forks.
Yeah, right. Me too, I guess.
All right. See you in Cam.
Yeah, for sure.
No, clearly I don't want to go to no play. Class play? No? Fuck that. Okay, yeah, the objective.
Pick up my DVD. I've still got time before class.
Get that DVD. Alright. Anti-drug poster.
Well, at least not for now.
See Warren or Brooke. See none of them. Don't even fucking bother. Now that we know who they are.
How could I possibly make it through a day in this place without a little chemical assistance?
Look, I'm gonna be that person right now. There are things that aren't good for you, and then there are things that people have lived to 100 or more years, and they've done. Research has shown, it hasn't even shown, it's just the case. There are people who drink wine almost every day and live to 110. Just depends on the rest of your health. There are people that smoke weed or, I don't know, take it, ingest it, whatever you wanna, and live to about the same age. It doesn't matter. Same thing. The drugs that she does aren't drugs. You're fine.
Nathan in tights. Can't unsee.
True. But yeah, back to what I was... You're fine. As long as the rest of you is healthy. Drink a lot of water. Eat a lot of really good vegetables. You're fine. Go to the picnic table. Thanks, on my way. Alright. Look who it is! Okay, I think she looks so much cuter in this one than she looked in the other one.
Victoria Chase.
When you see the rest of her.
I'd rather
her
vomit
face is
razor
different.
Blades than talk to her.
It's like less dressed and cute. I don't know.
Oh,
let's talk to her because you just said no.
It's Chloe.
It's Chloe.
Oh, right. I'm just teasing. People have been taking me so seriously since I won the Beacon's Young Artist Award for my photography.
She looks cuter there than she looks.
Between that and the Vortex Club, it's hard to keep people from putting me up on a pedestal or whatever. But you know all about that. What with Rachel Amber? Am I right?
Even though, like, maybe she's less of a bitch in the future because she knows things. I don't know.
Wait.
What
about Rachel Amber?
Rachel posted a slamming selfie of you two having the time of your lives. Do tell.
We didn't kill anyone. Don't even do that. Tell what?
Tell what, Victoria? It's a photo. Big deal.
But it's on Facebook. I mean, that basically means you and Rachel are like BFFs.
No, it doesn't. I've taken Facebook pictures of people I'm not best friends with. I'm just like friends or like I know them.
Is it drugs? I'm not judging or anything. I figure if she's hanging out with you, she must be into some effed up shit. You know?
Seriously, I don't know why you're talking to me about Rachel.
Oh, everybody loves her. Little Miss Perfect.
So you're jealous of Rachel Amber.
Yeah.
That's what's happening right now.
That's what's happening.
Gotcha.
Because I don't know anything about it, really.
I
barely saw her.
I didn't even finish the chemistry assignment, and you're being you.
Oh, Chloe probably did, right? This is hard. This is hard. This is hard because it's me. I trusted Victoria later on in the story, of the main one, that she was a good enough person that she would get what I was telling her, she would understand, that she would like us enough to trust us, and then she still gets kidnapped and still gets in trouble, and I feel really bad for that. I know that she's also friends with Nathan, friends with people who aren't too good, and also kind of want to sabotage her homework. We're gonna walk away, though.
Why would Rachel Amber ever hang out with Carrie Price?
It's Chloe.
Chloe, don't even fucking bother. Who walks like that? If someone called me Sammy or Samantha, I would be like, look. And just ignore it, too. I'd just be like, uh-huh, yeah, fuck you. My friends know what to fucking call me. Whatever. Who even fucking cares?
Evan's work is actually pretty good.
Who the hell is Evan?
I'd never tell him that, of course.
Someone she doesn't want to tell that his work is good, apparently.
This makes being high sound like a bad thing.
Chloe.
What the hell?
What have you got here, Twitch?
Don't call me that!
True North. A jock so dumb he makes jocks look bad. Guess Nathan Prescott made the shit list.
Oh, wow. This is some really weird crap,
it
Prescott.
It probably is pretty weird.
It's not yours.
It is pretty weird.
Give it back!
I hate that you're on the team now. You're such a loser.
Weird because you need help.
Guys, no need to fight. You can both be losers.
The mute speaks?
Done. I'm not mute.
Whoa,
what are you talking about?
You earn a spot on the squad, Twitch. You don't have your dad try to buy off the coach.
At least my family pays tuition. How much financial aid does your deadbeat dad need again?
Wow. Stop that.
Dick move, Nathan.
Yeah.
My dad lost his job at the shipyard when your dad closed it down. And you want to talk shit to me?
Leave Nathan alone.
Okay, this girl, stop.
You know something,
just because
Prescott?
She
I'm gonna do you a favor. You can't be a part of the team and be into this stupid crap at the same time.
You can. You can be into whatever you like. It doesn't matter whether it's like one extreme
You're
or the other.
A piece
I like
of
hockey
shit.
And I also like games.
I am going
stop
to
it.
Kill you.
You guys, stop.
But Why also
do something. Don't just stand there watching.
Don't tell me what to do. Okay, her name is Samantha, so I'm pissed right about that. But don't tell me what to do. I would not get involved.
Hey,
fuck that.
You don't take the time to stand back and watch. You miss some of life's finer moments. Like.
Booyah!
That.
That
sorry.
Took me months to put together.
I don't care.
Quit the team, Twitch. Or next time it'll be worse.
Well, don't tell him to quit, but it's still not my business at all.
Go to hell.
So there was a lot of opportunities that I could have played the Chloe's a badass, like, you know, rule.
You should be ashamed.
I'm not. I don't fucking care, Samantha. There's things you care about and things you shouldn't get involved with. When David was giving me something and I was like, it's like, be an asshole to him or just shut up. I'm just gonna shut up. In this case, I have nothing to do with the situation. I should just stop and say nothing. And I will look at what my mom said. Oh, okay. I ignored that and then, okay. I know you've been doing your best. Love you. How cute. Alright. Whatever, let's... fuck that. I feel bad for Nathan, and I feel bad for Drew North, right? That's his name, Drew? I feel bad for everyone.
Maybe if I delay going inside long enough, Blackwell will be overrun by future excellence.
Max.
And by future excellence.
Not Max.
I mean,
whoa!
More people.
Chloe, just go in! I literally can't go in. Oh, yeah! Because I'm supposed to get the DVD! Fuck. Yo, I forgot all about the DVD.
Need my DVD from Steph.
Yeah, well,
I bet
you should have told
me. Nerding it up with Mikey.
Yeah,
somewhere.
You should have told me. You should have reminded me about that before you even fucking headed to the door, bitch.
If I had known the Celestial Avenger was bloodied, I would have totally given him my potion.
It was a skill challenge. Potion wouldn't have worked.
Skill challenge?
It's part of the tabletop game we play.
You wouldn't understand.
Yeah, okay.
Give me a break, nerds. I've heard of tabletop games.
Cool.
Got my DVD?
Cool. One Blade Runner. Director's cut coming right up.
Of course that's what it was.
Sweet. $5, right?
Keep it. I'm just glad someone here appreciates the classics. You even asked for the director's cut,
so Steph cut
the shitty voiceover
okay.
and replaced it with a sweet dream sequence.
Dream life over real life. That's my motto.
Yo, I love it, man.
Right on.
Hey, do you know if Rachel's a gamer?
Rachel.
I'll fucking
Amber?
Know.
You're asking.
We
me?
Danced. That's
Didn't
all.
Did you two go out last night, or
we
was
literally
it just
danced
like
together?
A
I have no fucking clue. What's it to you?
Why do you want to know?
Steph has a crush
on Rachel.
Chloe, you should join her game.
Yeah.
Oh.
I don't have 50 hours right
Yo,
now.
Yo, sorry. So. Rachel is
We're
a little bit
campaign,
strange.
So
don't
take,
do that.
Like,
Chloe
minutes?
Has Max,
what
and
else have you got to
I'll
do
get
before
with
class?
Steph instead. Yeah, let's do it.
What the hell? Game on, nerds.
Here's a character sheet. You are an elf barbarian.
Before I answer this question, back in five. Alright, back. Okay,
Nice. Yeah. I could totally see myself as an elf barbarian.
Why not, right?
I know. I'm good. All right, let's get started. You are both famous heroes in the Kingdom of Avernon, a once peaceful land, now laid to waste by the bloodthirsty raiders of the Black Well. Alone,
Black
you have fought your
well.
Way through the raider camps, seeking their warlord leader, Durgaron, the Unscarred.
All right.
As you enter the final camp, bloodied and weary, you see your fellow hero approaching from the opposite direction.
I raise my staff to you in greeting. I am Elamon, wizard of the Third Circle, foremost advisor to King Tiberius, and sworn defender of Avernum.
Introduce your character.
Yeah, okay. I'm an elf barbarian named,
Hell fucking yes.
Calamastia.
Super into it.
Not bad.
The two heroes.
Hold on. Elamon narrows his eyes at the elf in front of him and says, I am here to defeat Durgaron, the Unscarred.
Durgaron.
In the name of King Tiberius, what makes you think you are worthy to fight alongside me?
I once stabbed a guy in the chest with a sword, and it went all the way through and killed the guy behind him, too. True story.
You stand at a three-way crossing.
No one has anything else
to your
say.
Left, the raiders' training
yeah, okay.
ground. To your right, their prison camp. Straight ahead, an enormous, ostentatious tent that could only belong to Durgaron, the Unscarred. Which way do you go?
All right.
Straight ahead, right? We're supposed to kill the dude.
Elamon frowns. The raiders could have some good loot at the training ground, and surely it is our duty to free all those prisoners.
I don't know how
Your
to beat
choice,
the actual
newbie.
Game. So here's
Where
the...
Where do you wish to go?
I have multiple comments right now. Comment number one. If you go onto their site, Steph's shirt is a real shirt, and I want it. And I need it. Okay, that's number one. Number two. No, this is not necessary to the gameplay, and that Chloe's real-life situation has nothing to do with, like, what I'm playing right now. This is so pointless. Number three, I thought it was kind of, also kind of cute that they added it, so I wanted to do it. And I don't remember 100% how to actually beat it, and slash not kill my character, Calamastia. So, let's see. I mean, like, the training... The camp, we can free people. The training ground, there's loot, I guess. So we loot.
Loot
duh.
Sounds good. Let's go to the training ground.
Always
Sweet.
Loot.
Upon
yeah,
arriving
loot.
At the training ground, you are spotted by a heavy-set orc who immediately shouts and points. There are a dozen raiders on the training field, all of whom raise their weapons and charge.
Okay.
Oh.
So what do we do?
I cast. Urgle's Acid Blast.
Already?
Overkill?
Bam!
You conjure up a wave of acid that washes over the charging orcs. Every raider suddenly starts screaming and writhing in pain. There's a sweet and sour kind of smell as the flesh melts off their bones like warm candle wax.
Oh. Holy shit.
You see why I haven't really needed a partner?
The heavyset orc sergeant still remains. He runs at you, swinging a massive warhammer.
All yours.
Alright, Fatal. This one?
I do a pommel strike. I strike his pommel hard.
What the fuck is that?
What did I say?
A pommel is the end of a sword handle. Pommel strike is where you hit the guy with it.
Ah, damn it. Okay, I do that.
Except you're not wielding a sword, you're wielding an axe.
It still works. Still the same fucking shit.
It's all right. Try using your...
You've delayed too long. The orc swings his warhammer at your head, barely missing. Your move.
Okay, well, we're gonna do this one.
Okay, let's end this. Fatal cleave.
You
go to chemistry, it said.
Downward with both hands. The orc blinks, then splits open like a hot dog bun.
Okay, well,
fuck
looks
yeah.
like I did fine.
I'm awesome at this game.
It's going well.
What about the loot?
Well, as the training ground is now a roiling pit of acid, it's unlikely any loot survived.
Your fault, hey. Dude. Whatever, I'll be nice.
Don't worry, Elamon guy. We all make mistakes.
Elamon nods. Calamastia, the elf barbarian, is most wise and forgiving.
What's next?
We could free the people. Do we free the people? Do we not care?
It's tent time.
Fuck it.
We can't just leave those prisoners there.
Why not?
You're right. Never pass up free slaves.
Not that way, Chloe.
Jeez. Where do you wish to go?
Thank you. Fine.
Guess it's time to free some peeps. Let's go to the prison camp.
You behold a field of standing iron cages, each imprisoning a human villager, calling
so,
out
like,
for you to
free them.
So, like, it was
not pointless to get
only
any loot, because you got no loot. This will be pointless, too, because he's going to go and
he
kill everyone.
You, and, in terror, runs into one of the few empty cages and locks himself in.
Well, then he's pointless. He locked himself in.
What's a dragonkin?
Dragonkin are, like, little dragon people. They're assholes. I bet he has all the keys.
Yeah, but what's it matter?
Okay.
At this point,
hey,
he locked himself in.
Get out of there!
The dragonkin hops up and down, shaking his ring of keys at you. He shouts in a strange language. Whatever he's saying probably isn't flattering.
Got any useful spells in that robe of yours?
Nothing that wouldn't blow up the cage and everything in it.
How about tell me what he's saying?
Intimidate.
All right, now
that's
I'll
a skill
it.
I have. Can I do that? I want the little bastard to shit his pants.
You can try. What do you say?
Listen up, you little lizard.
Unfortunately, he doesn't speak common, which means he can't...
I cast communication on the dragonkin.
There you
shit.
Go.
Really?
Now he can understand every word you say.
Time to work some real magic.
Thank
so
God.
So this is called a skill challenge.
Yeah,
you
I
try
know.
To use...
Oh, I know what this is. I grab the bars of the cage and lean in, nice and close.
He steps back. His scaly skin quivering in fear. What do you say?
I wiggle my hand. Hey, dragonkin guy. Want to become my meat puppet? How it works is I shove my arm up your ass into your head, and then I can control your mouth from the inside to say things.
He doesn't seem to like that idea.
Neither do I.
The dragonkin pleads with you. Please don't harm me, tall one.
Tall
but
one.
I cannot give you key. Durgaron, much taller and meaner than you.
You're short, I say. But you can always get shorter. Give me the key, or I'll chop off your legs and beat you to death with them.
Wow.
Dragonkin cowers before you, looking left and right. He opens his jaws, and you think he's about to yell for help.
I interrupt his yell by shoving my axe into the cage, pinning his head to the bars without hurting him. Then I say the following.
This is going to be good.
Here's what's up. I'm going to carve the skin from your bones.
Then I'm going to turn your skin into a little leather handbag that I'll shove your skinless body into so I can carry it around with me wherever I go. That way, the next time some asshat refuses to give me a key I want, I can pull your body out and show them what happens. How does that sound?
You get the key, man.
Wow.
That was nuts.
I'm going to give you a plus 10 bonus to charisma. Go ahead and roll.
That's what I thought.
A small pool of urine collects under the elderly dragonkin as, hands trembling, it hands you the keys. Then it dies of fear.
Good.
Awesome. Yeah.
Go team. Why don't you start unlocking the prisoners?
I'm on it.
As you free them, the prisoners run away from you in fear.
That's fine.
What's next?
Doesn't matter, as long as they run away, let's go!
It's tent time.
You enter the tent to find Durgaron, warlord of the raiders of the Black Well, sitting comfortably at his throne. He's a huge red-eyed minotaur.
Of course he's a
minotaur.
Swathed
in a fine black cloak, gripping a two-handed sword that's easily 6 feet long. His laughter bellows, wah, ha, 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 ha. Your lands and people are already mine. Your deeds here mean nothing. Your kingdom was weak. You are weak.
What an asshole.
I got this. I cast Zael's cataclysmic cone of fire.
The fire fizzles out on contact. Durgaron laughs again, holding up his right arm to show off his bracer of fire immunity.
Shit. All of my battle spells are fire-based.
Except
well,
for,
you,
you know, Acid Blast, which someone used unnecessarily to show off her cloak.
Maybe I shouldn't have done that then. Shit, alright, fuck. Now I remember, next time I play this, don't go to the loot, just do the prisoners. Okay. I don't know, all of it sounds pretty good.
Holy shit! Annihilation Strike! That sounds boss as fuck!
One?
That's bad, right?
Yeah.
Not for me. As you take your first step, you trip on a rock, collapsing onto the ground in a clangy jumble of metal. Your axe swings wildly to the side. Mikey, roll a reflex save.
Oh no. Three.
Your axe strikes Elamon's leg. Legs. Plural. Severing both feet at the ankles.
I am so sorry.
Durgaron moves toward the crippled Elmon.
Oh, shit!
I told you this was my best boss.
You didn't tell me my character might die.
Durgaron approaches, stomping his bloody hooves. Stomp. Stomp. Stomp.
This is all my fault. Sort of. What should I do?
It's not really your fault. It's his fucking moves are all fire-based. It's his fault.
I jump in front of Elamon.
Wow. Thanks, Chloe. I mean, thanks, Calamastia.
Okay. Durgaron has now turned his attention toward you.
Bring it.
He charges, thrusting madly with his great sword.
Shit!
Oh, no.
Your attempt to dodge his thrust fails. Durgaron laughs as
I
he impales on his blade,
fuck.
Lifting you high into the air.
Seriously?
I can't do anything with that stupid bracer. I'm sorry, Chloe.
Hey, I chopped your feet off. We're even.
You feel your strength draining away as Durgaron lifts you higher into the air. It hurts like hell.
Well, I lost
what
this.
What do you do?
I bring my axe down onto his arm. The one with the fire bracer thingy.
Oh, brilliant.
You'll have to roll high to hit. You're almost dead.
20!
Nice! Fuck yes!
You bring your axe down in a wicked chop, severing his arm completely. His bracer of fire immunity clangs to the ground.
I cast Gignomi's Fire Strike of Flame!
Ooh,
with no legs.
Lying
what,
on the
feet?
Ground. You conjure a flaming spear, which flies from your hands to spear Durgaron in the chest. incinerating him completely from the inside out.
Damn, Elamon.
Durgron is defeated, but your wounds were too great.
You both die.
I'm afraid Calamastia is dead.
Sorry, me. I did
good. I actually feel sad right now.
Better to have died a hero than live as a coward.
You're right, man. You're right.
That was fun.
Check out what I drew.
Maggie's got serious drawing skills.
Oh, cool. We killed it, man. Even though I died.
Glad you enjoyed it, Chloe.
Yeah. I'll adventure with you anytime.
Alright, man. Thanks for the game, nerds.
Alright, man. Even though that was totally unnecessary to literally anything.
DVD, check.
I still think it's cool.
Chemistry class.
I don't play D&D, but if it's something like that, then I probably would enjoy it. It sounds like it would be, right? I don't know the rules, so don't come at me, please. Hey, look who it is!
Oh, good. You're here.
Well, Miss Rachel. Alright. Oh, God. Once again, read the comics. Stressed. Just looking at Rachel makes me stressed because of it.
I do beseech you, chiefly that I might set it in my prayers. What?
Remember, this is before Max. She left.
Miranda. Oh,
Chloe thinks
my
this
father,
is her opportunity.
I
here.
Have broke your hest to say so.
Good. Admired Miranda. Indeed worth what's dearest in the world. Many a lady I have eyed with best regard, and many a time had listened to... many a time the harmony of their tongues hath I listened to.
Hayden,
I wouldn't know
you're
the line.
Killing me. You've had weeks to be off book.
Sorry, Mr. Keaton.
No, don't apologize to me. Apologize to your scene partner, who's been very accommodating.
She
and to your
like...
other fellow actors. And most of all, to yourself.
Mr.
Don't
Keaton,
do that to me.
Sorry to interrupt, but does this look better? I had my mom take it in a bit.
You
Rachel
look great.
Looks
awesome.
This is getting as surreal as last night.
Looking good, Rach.
Very cool.
Exquisite, Rachel, as always.
Mr. Keaton, I'm still having trouble with... My affections are then most humble. I have no ambition to see a goodlier man. I mean, does she really mean that?
Especially because I just straight out told her I've been banging all the ladies.
Yeah, that is hard. We've talked about that line forever. We need a fresh perspective.
Oh, God.
She's the question is, are Miranda's feelings of instant passion for Ferdinand just inexperience in dramatic circumstances, or has she actually just met the love of her life?
Oh, wow, I have so much to say
what
about
do you
this.
Think?
Do I think it's possible? Yes. Do I think it's possible in this circumstance where you're supposed to believe because you know that in the future it's not the love of her life because then she dies and then she has Max, who has she's met already. You know she's going on real circumstances here. Like, I know if you say it's true love, it's like you're literally telling Rachel that. Like, I kind of want to tell her that, and I also... Fine. Whatever.
Sometimes, when you meet someone who's going to change your life, you just...
Change
you
your
know
life,
it,
but not
I
necessarily
guess.
True love. Okay, I like it, I like it, I like
also,
it.
Also,
okay.
You've
okay.
got parents coming to see the show, right? At $20 a ticket, it's gotta be true love.
Alright, Chloe, I like it.
Wow. A romantic and a cynic.
Yes,
that
I like that.
That actually kinda helps me.
Yeah.
Thanks.
Good. Good stuff. I like it.
Thanks, Mr. Keaton.
Later.
See you later, guys.
Oh, no. I have first period improv with a class full of freshmen now.
Mr. Keaton, don't be rude to the freshmen, please. Hold on.
I'll just be a minute. Okay, so why am I here again?
Oh,
could you grab my belt for me?
No,
I think it's
Rachel.
In my bag over there.
You a belt? Yeah, sure.
Yeah, sure.
Okay.
Okay, get the belt. Don't say any stupid shit, and don't, like, fall down. Should be doable, right?
Okay, like, so it's... like, it's echoed for her brain, but did, like, hear how she said, like, oh, okay, right? Like, it sounded so believable. I love it so much. No, not that, man. A belt.
Rachel looks so happy here.
Look how small she is. Ignore that. I'm not tired. I don't know what you're talking about.
There's Rachel's belt.
All right. Okay, this
guess
chair
I'll
was shining.
I'll give this to Rachel now.
For some reason. Okay, what's this?
Hey now. Sharing is caring.
AKA Steph. And no, they're all gone.
I have feelings about this.
Okay, wait, oh,
most
but now we can know.
Most of them are not good feelings.
Who's the arm candy? Dude, that's Chloe Price. Taylor. Ah, okay. Like, they're like, oh my god, look, oh my god, yo, you had so much fun, but also like, who the fuck is like with you? Like, ooh, and then they were like, it's Chloe. Like, we all know her though.
Why do theater kids take themselves so seriously?
Because they want to get somewhere with it. A streetcar named Desiree. Brilliant. Oh, it does say Desire. I read Desiree. It's also brilliant. New title. She hopes to be a Vortex Club member as oh, wow. He auditioned on a dare. Okay. Interesting. Interesting.
This poster definitely says something.
Well, I don't know what it says. Wait, what? Rachel Amber sucks, says. Victoria Chase had any talent. She would have gotten the part of a talent. Oh, wow, okay. Got it. Anyway, here's your belt. Like, fuck. There's a lot of stuff happening here.
Rachel? Is this your belt?
Yes! Thank you.
Now we bring it. If you throw it over, it's like, eh. If you bring it, it's like, hey, bae, I might see you semi-naked. Ooh. Love it.
I really liked your costume.
Thanks. So? Did you bring flowers for my dressing room?
Fuck, I should have, man. Just a belt.
How about a belt instead?
Perfect.
I'll let you finish changing now.
She's so awkward, I love it. She gets
Chloe
changed so
Price.
Fucking fast.
Rachel Amber?
Last night was amazing.
Truth.
I'd never seen Firewalk live. Pretty fierce show.
We'll have to do it again.
Hell yeah.
To tell the truth, I went to bed last night wishing it never had to end. But then I thought, why? Why does it have to end?
Right, man? Right? That's what I think every show. Like, maybe it doesn't.
Maybe it doesn't have to end.
Exactly.
How awkwardly adorable.
How would you like to join me on a little field trip?
Let's do it. I don't know what you're talking about. Let's fucking do it.
Fuck yes. I was born to ditch.
Let's get the hell out of here.
Right now. Fuck it. Oh, I love it. Can I write these teenage angsty, like, shit? Can I write... My dream is to, like, be on the part of the team that writes this sort of stuff. Like, look at this teenage angst that I could have wrote and also loved.
Well?
What the hell am I getting into here?
Let's go, man, let's go. Look, she's taken away by Rachel's...
Where does this thing go?
Like, her energy, the way she just, like, moves with the flow.
Maybe we'll end up in Seattle.
She does not want to go to Seattle.
Pull up a chair, Price. The view's amazing.
All right, man. Let us do just that after I look at what the fuck this says. Oh, I skipped Kim. Yep. Yeah, fuck you right now, because I'm with Rachel.
Rachel wants me to pull up a chair.
Yeah, let's do it.
Maybe one of these crates.
Crates. I finished it for you, Chloe. Don't kick it off the fucking train. Sit, man.
I guess I should sit down. All right, Chloe. You're on a freaking train with Rachel freaking Amber. Play it cool.
You skip class.
This nervousness.
It's so cute.
Is that what this feeling is?
You like her. It's
so
cute.
Max were here, so I could ask.
She doesn't know. Like, I don't feel like
she
knows.
Should I make small talk? Is that
I love
what people
this.
Do?
It's like she really doesn't know. Like, she doesn't realize that she liked Max, and she doesn't realize that what this is. Like,
what is wrong with you?
I am awkward and
You're
cute.
You're acting nervous.
Yep. I am.
So, it's kind of weird that we're hanging out.
Yep.
You mean because I don't hang out with anyone and I don't have any friends?
You have friends.
Well, I used to. Friend. Singular. Her name was Max, but she left for greener, more northern pastures.
That sucks.
Yeah. Say thanks.
Hey, so, I want to say thanks.
For pulling you out of school?
No, yesterday.
Oh, dummy. Thanks for last night. If you hadn't shown up.
Assholes abound in Arcadia Bay.
Yep.
I owe you. That's for sure.
Is that why you came along?
No.
I should need a reason to ditch school.
Cute girl just ditched. Sorry.
I bet you're wondering what we're doing.
But...
The thought occurred, yeah.
Well... I wanted some company.
Okay.
That's it?
I won't question it.
That's it?
Yeah, alright. Yeah, sure.
Good to fucking go. Anything beats another second in Blackwall.
You really hate it there, don't you?
Yep.
You don't? Right. What reason would Rachel Amber have for hating Blackwell Academy?
She does well.
Your high school royalty. You don't know me. Yet.
I was gonna say you right, but alright. Yet, I like it.
Let's do something fun.
Alright, I will. Get down, Matt. Flirt.
V-card's been punched, Rachel. I'm sorry.
Wow.
Too far.
Well, I don't know.
I like it.
Okay.
I gotta use that.
I'm all ears. Two truths and a lie.
What?
I think we should play Two Truths and a Lie. It's a game where each person offers up three facts about themselves, two of which are the truth, and one of which is
a lie.
Right. Mm-hmm. And then the other person has to guess which is which.
All right, let's go.
Sounds fun. You're on.
I'll start. First, I'm ambidextrous.
Maybe. Okay.
Second, I was born in New York.
You weren't.
Fashion and Broadway.
Nope.
To which I will one day return when
Lie.
My heinous exile here in Arcadia Bay comes to an end.
New York, huh?
No.
I've never been.
I have.
Not a world traveler?
Not yet, at least.
One day, Chloe.
If you could travel anywhere, where would you go? Russia, Greece, Kathmandu?
Kathmandu?
One day, I'm going to climb Everest.
And I thought moving away from Arcadia
Bay
was ambitious.
I'd go to Japan. But I've gone to L.A. and, or I've gone to San Fran, and I've gone to
Two truths and a lie. You say three things.
New York,
right.
So close enough.
I'm a Leo. Meow.
Yeah, you are that.
Okay.
Yay, fucking
so,
are.
So ambidextrous, born in New York, and a Leo.
Nope.
Gotcha.
You ain't born in New York, man.
So, which is the lie?
The Leo is right. Which is the lie?
You seem more like a Cali girl to me.
Yeah, you are.
Damn, Price, not bad. Long Beach, in fact. West Coast is the best coast.
Fuck not.
I've only
no,
ever
it
lived
ain't.
In Oregon, so nothing to compare it to, I guess.
East Coast, man.
Then we'll have to change that one day, won't we?
You gotta go to the East Coast to find out that you don't want to live here.
Okay, your turn, Price.
All right, man.
First
I like
fact.
The, hey, we,
right.
You know, Floridiness here.
Something about myself.
We're gonna do it truthful.
Should I start
truthful.
Things off with a lie
nah.
The truth?
Two truths and a lie, you know?
Or should I cheat?
No, we're no cheating.
Let's see how good she really is
at
this
game. No cheating. We're gonna go the lie first. We are going to say that we're in a band. That sounds right.
I'm secretly the lead guitarist of an all-girl Misfits cover band called the Misfits.
I believe that.
Impressive.
So, okay. Now, that was a lie, so now we're gonna go two truths, because that's the game. And we're gonna play it right.
I used to want to be a pirate when I grow up. I kinda still do.
Ninjas, though. Arr. Arr, I like it. Okay, again. And we like science.
I love science. Seriously. I think Neil deGrasse Tyson is the shit.
He is, man.
Huh.
Okay, go ahead. Go ahead.
You're hella mysterious, Chloe Price.
Hella?
Hella? Who says that?
You!
It's a Cali thing.
No. Oh, I love it so
anyway,
much.
I think I have your number.
Alright, let's go.
Of course you wanted to be a pirate. Sail the open seas.
Uncle Swash.
Plunder secret treasure.
Did I mention my love of booty?
It's good. It's a good one.
So, pirate. Obviously true.
Okay. Ooh.
Maybe you'd like to be my first mate.
Oh. Are you accepting applications?
Considering it.
Oh, I like it.
Okay. You say you love science, but you are failing chemistry.
Listen, school sucks.
You're saying failing chemistry means I hate science?
Or that Blackwell doesn't inspire your best work.
There you go. You're right.
That place is a hellhole filled with shit, where shitty people go to be shitty to each other and themselves.
Yep.
Tell me how you really feel, though.
Yep.
Anyway, school sucks, but you love science. I'm gonna say true.
Thank you.
So, let's talk about this lead guitarist.
You don't play the guitar.
The business of show.
As much as I'd love to be a groovy to your all-girl cover band, the Misfits, I'm gonna have to call lie on that one.
You don't think I can rock?
On the contrary, you absolutely rock.
Thank you.
The problem is, your hand is smooth, no calluses. You don't play guitar.
Alright.
Pity too. You'd look hot on stage. So, if my math is correct, you told me two truths and one lie.
At the game, man.
What?
I did it right.
You expected me to cheat?
Winners make their own rules, Chloe.
You are crazy good at this game.
A lifetime of studying the human condition.
Psychologist?
Well, I'm impressed.
I bet it's hard to impress Chloe Price. I'm gonna feel good about that one.
Good.
When your dad is the district attorney, I guess lying is something you're used to.
Seriously?
Seriously.
I know who to call if I need to get out of a ticket, then. Not that I have a right of my own. Car first, embarrassing number of moving violations second.
Hey, thanks for trusting me.
Even I would fall for
trusting
Rachel
you?
For that. Like, with like what she's how she talks.
And not everyone would admit to wanting to be a pirate.
Yeah, they
but
would.
Eye
fuck
patches
that.
Are so cool.
And rum is delicious.
Truth.
I guess. You opened up a lot. That's all.
Not really. Thank you, though.
It's not a big deal.
Hate to break it to you, but Chloe Price is not exactly renowned throughout Arcadia Bay as a bastion of trust and empathy.
Bastion. Haha. I don't know. Wow. It would make it really easy to... Look at that face! You'd fall for her easily. Shit. I want to be like, I trust you. Trust is hard.
Trust doesn't exactly come easy to me. Maybe if you'd had my life, you'd understand.
No, I get that.
On the other hand, I got on this train with you, didn't I?
Fair point.
Yeah. Yeah, that's true. Wow. Wow. Kiss already? Jesus Christ.
Wouldn't mind listening to some music.
No, kiss. Just, yeah, well, yeah, you're not gonna listen
hey,
by yourself, man.
Wanna listen?
Yo, I don't know, dude. Just, I don't know how Rachel talks in general. I would be like, yeah, I'd fall for you too, and it would be bad, because she's not someone who's it's gonna last with, I guess. Obviously, as you know, that it's Chloe Max, yeah. Wow. Are you coming now? Now the start is inside. Oh, listen for a second. Give me a second. Now history sighs. I feel peace. I feel peace. Are you one of us?
Are you one of us? Cool bracelet.
I've had it, I guess, since I was a kid in Long Beach. It reminds me that there's more to experience out there than just Arcadia Bay.
I like it.
Maybe one day I'll go back to Long Beach.
I have stuff from Japan that
anywhere,
reminds me that too. Even though
maybe
I haven't been.
Sooner than later.
Yo, I'm not gonna say what.
Me too. Arcadia Bay can suck a bag of dicks.
Sometimes I feel like I've got no reason to stay.
I feel that
don't
now about here,
Chloe,
man.
If one day I'm just out of here,
let me know if you need an accomplice.
Check it out. We're here.
Yo, tell me when
what?
You leave.
Where is here? Jump and find out. Did you say jump? Jump!
Okay.
Fuck it.
Remember to tuck and roll. From here to like down here, you know? Diagonally so you don't hurt yourself. I'm a ninja in training. Duh. Someone horribly jogging. All right. Chloe's like, hold up, don't wait. Stop walking so fucking fast. Where are you going?
Actually a pretty nice view. Glad you approve. And as your reward for making it up here, I have a new game for us to play.
Okay.
Another one? I like games. Deal with it. This is one I learned in theater class. It's all about improvisation.
That's one of my favorite games in general. All right. Ooh, we're gonna do this though.
So far, what I've learned about you is that you're into acting, lying, and playing games. What's your point? That you're either full of imagination or full of shit. Hmm. Let me know when you figure out which one.
Oh!
This game involves spying on people from afar. Luckily, we got some high-tech surveillance equipment right here. Let's fire it up.
All right. No, doesn't work? All right. Well, sorry. I'm sorry, Rachel.
That blows. Well, shit.
Hey, we'll figure it out. Hold on.
That was my last quarter. You?
I'm poor, but...
Quarterless.
Oh, we'll figure it out. We'll figure it out. Hold on.
Hey,
hold on, hold on.
Maybe I can MacGyver something up. I've been told I'm pretty handy. Oh, yeah? Let's see what you got.
You get it? Handy? Okay. Calm down, Rachel. I got this.
Rachel
got this.
Really wants to use this viewfinder. I'd love to get it working for her.
Alright, no. Stop that, Sam. We got this. I remember it has something to do with this, so let's do it.
I've always said the Prescott family has a couple screws loose.
Hehe. Do they actually have screws loose? Okay. Oh, wait. Oh, we need something from her first. Ignore the bird. Rachel, hold on. Can you give me something?
Totally gonna get you that quarter. Love the confidence. Would love a quarter even more.
I got this. Can you give me something? You have something that I need, though.
That is the look of a person who is used to getting what she wants. Wonder what that feels like.
Aww.
Kiss her, ready.
Okay,
Looks like I might be able to pry it open with the right tool.
Please.
I'm not getting in there with just my fingers. Maybe Rachel has something I can use?
She does, but not really. She has something else.
I'm thinking about prying open that viewfinder. Got a knife on you? A knife?
I do.
Yeah. My mom took mine. No. How about a nail file?
Perfect for something else. Can you give me that? Thank you.
I guess you could stab someone with a nail file.
You could, but not really.
Oh.
She gives you like a...
Right.
Face.
Sure. Let's try it.
All right. But not really. Don't break the nail. Let's not. Victoria? What? I did nothing. I literally didn't do anything. Rachel Amber obviously played you last night. You'll be lucky if she ever talks to you again. I'm literally with her, but okay. Victoria, I didn't... One, just because I didn't step in the middle doesn't mean that I'm at fault. Like, it would have happened to him anyway if I wasn't there. You know what I mean? Two, I'm with her right now. What are you even fucking talking about? Anyway, Yeah, unscrew it with this. A nail file. Chloe, you should have a little knife. You shouldn't have a... Don't throw it on the ground. Maybe she could still take it back. Whatever.
Stealing a dedication plate.
A little knife is good. Don't kill someone with it, but you never know what you need. To open a box? Oh no, seriously. Cool. Good shit. So the principal's out for us, knowing that we skipped, but Steph and Mikey are happy about it. I like it. Alright, now I think I have what I need. Don't glitch. And go.
Prescott power, activate.
You know it'll work too, just because you said that. Like, seriously. Take that quarter, man. Rachel, come here. I got you something. Not to brag.
I don't want to boast, so I'll let you do it for me. Chloe Price, you are truly the Viewfinder Whisperer. I stand in awe of your powers.
Thank you, thank you, thank you. I love it. Alright.
Rachel smells like jasmine.
Aww.
Is she smelling me right now too? Really should have showered this morning.
Oh my god, that's me 100,000%.
Here's the game. You find some people for us to spy on, and then you and I will act out what they're saying and thinking.
I like it, okay.
That's it. I do that in my head during, like, every class. See? You're a natural. Let's give it a try.
Okay. Yo, well, I know what I want to do, but...
Hey, what do you say we barbecue some squirrels when we're done here? God, you just have the best ideas.
Barbecue some squirrels.
Loving this guy. What's he thinking right now?
No matter how fast I go, I'll never outwalk this wedgie.
That's so tragic, but also beautiful in its own way.
Me. Okay.
What's going on with these two?
And the Lord setteth, thou shalt make a burnt offering of your firstborn son.
Who are you talking to, Dad?
No one, son. Now, lean into the grill and see if the fire started. Further. Further.
Wow, that was dark. Too dark. Perfect dark.
That's what I thought.
All right, let's see.
Ooh, I don't know.
Why do we always hold hands like this? Didn't you tell me you were ambidextrous?
No, I didn't. I said I was ambisexual.
Oh, so you can have sex with both of your hands?
Exactly. Wanna see?
Yeah. Only if you let go of my hand first.
That is pretty good.
This is fun. Who's next? Oh, Sorry. Didn't mean to hog the viewfinder. Jackpot. Commence makeout session in 3, 2, 1.
Good timing, Matt.
Nailed it. Damn, they are really going at it.
We're not gonna say prostitutes. That sounds mean.
I think we used the vibrating bed for too long. I'm totally seeing double. Rachel? Hey, are you all right?
What are we doing?
Excuse me?
Last I checked, you're supposed to be Chloe Price. Yet we've been ditching now for hours, and we haven't even gotten wasted yet.
Oh, okay.
That's got to be against some school ditching rule.
It's not. I don't always get wasted, but... You didn't drink, Chloe. Why lie?
Hell yeah. The honor student wants to show the school delinquent at a party? Be my guest.
How gracious of you.
Okay. Don't say it like that. Let's go. Oh, God.
They have a bottle of wine.
Probably not good.
Let's steal it.
Okay.
Or we could go try to find a liquor store instead.
No. You shouldn't bring alcohol to a public park if you're not willing to share it with everybody, right?
Not really. If I brought wine, I wouldn't want you to have it, Rachel.
I just want to take something that's not mine.
Okay.
All right. I'm going in. Try to keep up.
Oh, God. Okay. Oh, my Lord. Chloe's like, I don't really know. This is smart.
Can we help you?
No.
Oh, my God.
I would take a
shit.
Run.
Talk about committing to a performance. There it is. Time to snatch and run.
What?
That's not snatching, Chloe. That's slow.
Oh, thank God. Please, this girl is in trouble. Go get help.
I need to get these two to focus on Rachel so I can swipe the wine.
What are you waiting for? Go!
Don't look at me. Look at Baywatch over here. I don't remember how to do CPR. Wah. It's time to nut up or shut up.
Watch out. I'm going to check her pulse. That's on her neck, right?
And her wrist.
I still think
her...
you should go get help. There's a ranger station on the other side of the park.
Good point. We'll keep watch while you go.
Watch.
Oh, shit! That sounds like rabies to me.
Rabies?
Yep, definitely rabies. Better pay close attention to make sure she doesn't try to bite you.
Okay. You can do this. I can't do it.
Pathetic.
Look. He's clearly useless. This woman needs help from someone who actually knows what they're doing.
So you get down there and say, knows what they're doing,
oh, shit! Now I'm starting to feel sick, too. I think it's contagious. You'd better run away before it gets you, too.
Hold on. There's something off about this. Are you girls putting us on?
What are you talking about?
Rachel! Run!
What the hell?
Really? That was dumb as fuck. Who would do that? You guys are idiots. Well, okay. Run faster and farther than that! Farther. Rachel, can you chug it after we go a lot farther than that?
Oh. So, maybe your acting could use a little work, but...
A lot.
At least you committed to the performance.
Give me
Thanks.
That. Like, not even give me that, but give me that. Let's go farther, and then give me that.
I could use a drink after trying to keep up with you.
Yeah. Okay, but you should have gone a lot farther than what you got. They could have caught up to you.
I am excessively sober.
Wait until it hits.
Right.
Let's go farther. Okay. Jesus Christ.
Guess we're leaving now.
Wine isn't the same as liquor, but you guys are idiots. Whatever. Oh my god. Gah. Oh, look, the fucking train tracks. Makes me sad. If I was Chloe, it would make me miss Max, even though it didn't happen yet.
Whoa. Hey, check this out. What?
No, she drank more than you, so she's not sober anymore. A weird bliss. Maybe it's the sunset.
Great. It's a pile of trash.
Yeah. An awesome pile of trash.
Let's explore.
You have fun, Chloe. I'm gonna go sit down.
Rachel's been acting kind of standoffish ever since we left the park.
Talk to me.
What's her deal?
Chloe, I'd really like some space right now.
No, fucking tell me what it is. You called me out here. You made me ride this train with you. Fucking tell me what's up.
Okay. Actually, no. I thought we were having a great day together. Why are you acting like this all of a sudden?
I'm not acting like anything. I just want to be left alone right now.
Yeah, but I get it, but we're not even home. If you were home, if you want to be left alone, that's one thing, but...
Yeah, I get it. I know I'm not the easiest person to be around. I don't exactly have tons of experience with the whole friendship thing.
Not everything revolves around you, Chloe.
I didn't really mean to make it about me, I'm sorry.
I didn't say it did. I'm just saying I understand.
No, you really don't.
Wow, I don't?
Fuck.
That's not what I meant.
Shit.
Not what I meant. I meant like, yeah, I get
okay.
it.
I
but also,
still
we're
have
not
no
home.
Idea what's going on with Rachel, but apparently she gets smashy when she's angry. I can work with that.
I know what Chloe wants. Okay, whatever, I'll just do it.
Score.
Hit something besides me with this. We're gonna show her.
Hey, check it out. I don't always drink beer, but when I do, I prefer drinking it next to an old toilet.
Home run!
Okay,
can
cute.
I see?
Absolutely.
Sure.
I asked you to leave me alone.
Alright.
Are you kidding me? I know you're the school princess and all. With the DA daddy and the perfect grades and all the perfect little Victoria Chases kissing your perfect ass. But seriously, fuck you. Great. I'm leaving. See you around, Chloe.
You can't leave!
Watch me.
Rachel,
wait! Don't go.
Rachel, just tell me what's up.
Why not?
Tell me what's up. You can't just all of a sudden act pissy.
Because I don't want to ruin this the way I ruin everything else in my life.
Just tell me.
And what is this exactly?
I don't know. Well, I'm obviously gonna say this.
I mean, Fuck. Are you actually going to make me say it?
Yeah.
Say what? Say it. Exactly. You know, like a friendship. But more. Ah. I know. Weird, right? It's just, today was the best day I've had since my dad died. And when I almost ruined it just now, the way I ruin everything, it made me realize whatever's going on between us is special.
Chloe, aw. But also Rachel's fucked up a little bit, can't you tell?
Say something. Chloe, I'm sorry. I'm really, really
not
sorry.
Not in a bad way, fucked up. I'm just saying, like, she's got some stuff, but she won't tell you what it is. If she told you, then that's one thing. If she doesn't tell you, then she doesn't want you to know. Yet, I mean, obviously you don't really know each other. She said she wants to.
Why not?
So there's plenty of time.
Because I can't.
She's got time. She's got time. It's possible. Anything is possible. Okay. Okay, she touched your face, so that means that she'll tell you eventually. Look.
Goodbye, Chloe.
No, you'll tell me soon. Stop it. Come back here. Fuck. Aww. Okay. Well, she wants us, and also, she doesn't know how to accept that because she's got a lot going on right now. Which makes sense. Chloe, none of this is your fault. Literally, none of this.
Fuck.
I know you. I know you feel like it is. Look at the options. Smash, 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 smash. I know you feel like this is your fault, but it's not. Answer your mother. I know I was gonna do better. I'm sorry.
I'm sorry,
Bob. Look, I was gonna do better, but then I got into it with Rachel and, Look, that's her car in the future.
If you want to rip a family apart from the inside, it's important to bring the proper tools.
Chloe, none of this is your fault. Rachel just is a very, very, very different person in her own. Thank God she didn't do that with her fist.
You know she's fake. You can't take your eyes off her. Who else do I know who fits that description?
Wow.
Fuck off,
sorry.
Rachel.
I'm so sorry. The thing is, you feel this way after just knowing her. Like, imagine knowing someone for longer. Ooh, the camera.
I've never understood your hard-on for cameras, Max. You took a million pictures of us, and not one of them showed that you were gonna leave when I needed you most.
She'll come back for you.
Fuck cameras.
I love you two so much. Shit! Your eventual car? Hard as hell. Wow. I literally couldn't even imagine that. I'm thinking about the car accident that I got into that ruined my car, but I'm fine. I was fine. And everyone else is fine. I couldn't even imagine this. My car was not fine, though. Everyone else was, though. Yeah. Don't hurt yourself, though. I would hug you if I could, but you're digital, so I tried. Oh no, not another dream.
I just called to tell you that I miss you, my old friend.
Why are you crying, sweetheart?
Because you died. Oh my god.
Because you're not real.
I'm not.
No.
What is going on?
You have a different voice actor too, I think.
What's past is prologue and shit.
Kiddo, look on the bright side, would ya?
What bright side?
You made a new friend today.
You did. Ish? I don't even know.
Hey, where's my marker?
No.
Oh, there it is.
Oh, the marker's literally.
Gotta say, that was some fight. A lover's quarrel, you might say?
Who knows?
She nearly took your head off.
Alright, so the tree is of importance.
What do you care?
Sorry, sweetheart. I guess I'm getting into your personal business.
Lover's quarrel because she like knew right away that like she kind of liked her. Truth, man, this is a dream. You write the truth. Did I not do this in the first one? I guess.
Dad used to hate it when I wrote on shit. Sleep is for the weak.
Yeah, sleep is for the strong, man.
I guess I did that.
Sometimes people need you, though. Even when they don't admit it.
What a weird dream. Chloe, I'm so sorry.
Mitchell!
that you slept in the car that your dad died in. I don't know that I'd even be able to fall asleep. That's fucking... At the same time, it is exhausting, so I kind of get it in a weird way. But, that's so sad. Back to the train tracks leading you to new paths. Alright, Chloe. Head back to Rachel? Yep. Found you. Yo,
You came.
I did.
I'm glad.
You too.
Hey. I couldn't let the day end with whatever this afternoon was.
Chloe, I want to talk to you about something, but...
Good.
I don't know how to talk about this.
That's okay.
You don't have to tell me anything you don't want to.
You remember that guy that we saw under this tree with that woman?
The ones who were making out?
That was my dad.
Oh. All right.
And that woman was definitely not my mom.
Oh.
The worst part is... I'm not surprised. I felt like my dad's been lying about something for a while. I didn't know what it was.
Aw, I'm sorry.
When I saw he got a text from an unknown number asking him to meet, I thought I could catch him or something.
And you did.
I'm so sorry, Rachel. I don't know what to say.
Neither do I.
Yeah.
Chloe, I love my dad.
Yeah, you should.
I love him. And I never want to see his fucking face again.
I know. But Chloe doesn't have a dad. So...
My dad died. I was so mad at him. For months, I felt... wrong, because half the time I thought of him, I wanted to scream. And the other half, I forgot.
Forgot that anything had changed?
Yeah. Probably. Crazy, right?
It's silly, but I've carried this photo around with me for years. Uh-huh. It's from Mount Hood. My dad took me hiking there when I was 10, and it started raining, and I fell and broke my arm 3 miles from the car. I remember screaming like I was gonna die, but my dad, he carried me down the mountain. I still remember the smell of his coat, and how calm he was, and the sound of his voice, and...
Alright, oh god... I know her wants space, but Chloe, I feel like, would try. I would try. Okay. I would try, too.
It's just so strong, you know? I felt safe.
You trusted him.
Completely.
Here.
Chloe, I owe you an apology.
It's okay.
Don't worry about it.
No, I mean it. Whatever's going on between us, it's intense and new and awesome, and you had the courage to tell me that you feel it too. And I treated you like shit.
Courage? I don't know if I'd call it that. More like blind desperation.
Me?
And maybe a slight buzz from that wine.
Aw.
I just want you to know, I'm lucky that you were with me today. You're a badass, Chloe Price.
What?
Remember that biker asshole who wouldn't let you into the mill?
Oh, you know about that?
You talked your way right past him.
Yeah, I did.
You saw that?
And those skeevy douchebags who followed you upstairs? Two against one. But you wouldn't take any shit from them.
Yeah,
I'd be dead if you
do.
Hadn't thrown that bottle.
You inspired me.
Okay. I like it.
See? You're the real thing, Chloe. I don't know anyone like you.
Right.
Plus, you came along with me, no questions asked.
Well, I don't really need a good reason to ditch school.
I guess
hot girl,
tomorrow
school
there'll
ditch.
Be hell to pay.
My mom might skip grounding and just go straight to the death penalty.
Nah.
And my dad will definitely punish me with...
I'm sorry.
I'm so sorry, Rachel.
Fuck him.
But you said it, so I didn't
to
have to.
This place and never look back.
What's stopping us?
Us?
Yeah, man.
Are you serious?
Yeah,
there's
man.
Nothing keeping me here. Not anymore.
Except...
So, if I came to you tomorrow and told you to pack your bags...
I'm serious. Let's do it, Chloe. Let's leave this place forever. Okay.
Yo, my ass would wipe her tears. And then be like, are you serious, though? Because, like, let's do it. Okay. Hugs? No?
Can I borrow your lighter?
Yeah, how did you know I have one?
Thank you.
A controlled burn. Let's not go crazy. But I already know what happens, so. Probably would stay very contained right within there if you just left it.
Come on.
Leave it. Leave it. Yeah, come on. Leave it. Leave it, leave it, leave it, leave it. And... Whoa. So... I won't say anything if you're suspecting something paranormal. I won't say it. Because it's this series. Anything is possible. So I won't say anything. Oh my god. She screamed so loud and it vibrated so hard that it actually it actually fell off my lap. Wow. Okay, Rachel, I understand. Some real things happening. Wow, okay. Wow. Literally vibrated right off my lap. The thing felt my headphones disconnected, everything happened right there. That was a lot of things. Wow. Okay. Well, then, so there's a giant fire in the forest. Wouldn't you fucking leave? Or, like, be like, what the hell is that? Because I would. I'd be like, yo... Bye. Does everyone drink the same beer? Yes. What the fuck is that? Someone call the fire department. What the hell? I mean, I know what it is, but like, you know, they don't. Seriously, I'm sorry, Nathan, but at the same time. Seek help? I don't know. There we go. Or not? I don't know what they're talking about. that Prescott? No, 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 no. That's Rachel's dad. I think. Don't smoke a cigarette right next to the burn. Well, wow, that's the very interesting start here. Our baby Chloe, back in the past. Pre-blue hair. Same punk attitude. It's a lot of things. It really is. I love her, though. So, I feel like, honestly, like, just playing Max, you get the idea of who she is. And, like, why Max likes her. I think. I mean, I felt, I don't know. So, then when you play as her, you can kind of feel, like, maybe what she's going through with certain of the, like, with some of these situations. And how, I don't know, I feel like she would be kind of awkward in some of this, first love kind of, like, situations. Where she'd be like, maybe you're flirting with me and I'm just gonna go for it because I'm slightly more of a badass, but still awkward. You know what I mean? Whereas, like, some people would just, like, not say anything and it would, like, never, like, amount to anything. I feel like she would do something about it and she'd actually go for it. It would just, you know, it wouldn't be the smoothest. So I like it. I did not attack. Apparently some people are way more badass than I am. In that situation, I would have just booked it. You know, peace out. You know? Like, if you had to attack in self-defense after the fact, like, if they then ran after you and you knifed them or you something, that's one thing. I wouldn't go first. I would run first. Hell yeah, I'm kind of Joyce. Joyce is amazing. Okay, the reason people defended Nathan was not because they liked Nathan. The reason people defended Nathan was because it gave them the choice with the two little skull things next to it that were like Chloe's, what's the, you know, they felt that advanced the actual gameplay, that like that there was more to that if they did it that way. Like, guaranteed. It had to do with, like, her little back talk. That's what I was looking for. Her little back talk thing. It gave you that. Realistically, I would have stayed the fuck. This has nothing to do with me. I mean, yeah, everything has to do with everyone in this town. In fucking Blackwell. And you know, Arcadia Bay. Everything has to do with everyone. But at the same time, that doesn't have to do with me. Fuck it. Nathan can get his shit thrown somewhere, and Drew was an asshole, and everyone's an asshole, and whatever. You know what I mean? I don't. I get it. It would have been more fun to, like, go in with it and, like, you know, be like, you guys are both pussies and whatever and whatever. Yeah, but not my fight to fight. And if you fucking paid attention to anything that happened in the original game, you were pretty clear. It was pretty clear that Chloe thought of Rachel, even if not the first day she met her, or the second, whatever, I guess, technically the second. Well, she met her before, she just didn't actually, like, hang out with her, whatever. The time they've actually spent together. It was clear that she felt more than just friends. Like, even if this was, like, months after, it was clear that that was the eventual goal. So, yeah, you were trying to lead it towards that. Like, duh. So. Shit. Oh, God.
No one steals from me!
Oh.
I want my fucking money!
Great. Oh, next episode starting in... No, hold on. Did you see that countdown? It was like, next episode starting right now. We're gonna do this to you. No, 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 no. Listen. No, no. I know what happens. But I don't need to start it right now. Jesus Christ. Just because I have them all doesn't mean you have to do that to me. No, we stop here for now. That was the first episode. Awake, apparently. Oh, my Lord. But yeah, I feel like it was very clear that, like, they both had something more than just friends. I mean, like, even if it was just more enough that they had eventually meant to be roommates and meant to move out together and meant to, like, start a different life, they were still more than just friends. They were their best friends or more. You know what I mean? So it was like, you knew that Chloe felt something else, even if Rachel didn't. Because that was the whole, like, that was just how she reacted and things, so. She called her angel. I mean, come on. But, anyway. I think that's where I end it for now. Well, I'll be back for episode 2-3 and the beautiful bonus episode where the voice actors return. They were on a strike for Before the Storm, but whatever. I mean, I don't remember what it was actually for, but when it comes to what the voice actors are, I get it. I totally get it. Do what you need to do. But for who they chose for everyone, I love what they did. When it comes to actually getting, like, something that really means something to the fans, whether they know anything, like, what the game actually amounts to. Like, it doesn't matter about what all of that means. Like, what's actually produced is great. Not even though it's not the, like, originals for the book, for everyone. But, like I said, though, I really am into voice acting, so when they do bring the originals back, I fucking love it. So, that's the bonus episode, though. So, for the rest of this, you have a semi-fake Chloe, so if you need to do what I do and go back and watch one real episode of the original so you can get Chloe's real voice back in your head, that's what I do. So, go do that, and then come back for the next part with me, probably either tomorrow or within the next few days, and that is when I'll see you next. So, I'm out for now. Peace. Bye.